Why did you decide to start your tour in Toronto?
I think we were planning on starting on the East Coast, so I really have no idea. Ask my manager. I don't even pay attention to the itinerary or where we're going. I mean, I'm glad I'm here. I'm going to put this in someone's drink. I'm glad we're in Canada. I had no idea that we were even going to come to Canada, really. I mean, I expected to come sometime this year on tour, but I just don't pay attention to the itinerary or where we're going because, well, I can't say that it's all the same, but it's just, it's more exciting that way, just showing up in a town. I don't really like to pay attention to the politics or, you know, what's going on in the band at all.
You seem just along for the ride. You just want to distance yourself from all the administrative stuff and just play.
Exactly. Yeah, that's why we have a manager now, and he sets things up like this. I mean, of course, he communicates with Chris, and Chris will tell me, you know, basically what's going on, but, you know, if there's anything that we don't like, we'll let them know. It's not like we don't care, and we're not listening, and they just set up whatever we want, and, you know, we just go along.
But you don't really care for doing that much in the way of interviews, but that's just, you're is it because of overkill or just frustrated with it?
I think it's both. It's just, I'm getting really bored with the same questions all the time. It's understandable, and I also realize that most of the interviews have to ask the standard questions because there's not much of a, you know, we don't have much of an image and there's not much story behind our band, and so what people can grasp, they, you know, base their interview off of that. But getting really tired of the independent going over to major label stuff. I mean, it's happened and there's nothing we can do about it, so there's no sense analyzing it, you know.
So do you feel that going to majors really brought you a lot more ignorant interviews?
Not necessarily. You know, I've realized that a lot of the people we've done interviews with this time around are the same people we've done interviews with before, in the same magazines. We hardly have had any interviews in the States, but I've noticed that more in Europe, where usually they're friends of ours in the first place. It's almost like a little conspiracy. They're not going to write shit about us. You know, they're not going to put us down, make us sound like fools. So it's good in that sense, but it's just getting boring, you know? I don't blame them for asking the same questions.
Well, are you getting a big push from your label now that you're on
the major? Yeah, they're really excited. They're sincerely excited and they like the music. They really do.
It's like $750,000. It's quite a big investment.
$750,000. No, we didn't get that much.
It wasn't that much? That's what I read. How much was it that you got?
175. 33% tax bracket, 15% to our lawyer, 10% to our manager, $70,000 to Sub Pop. Left us with about $20,000 to buy equipment. I don't have a place to live at this moment.
Not in your contract? John Castor from the Doughboys, I know, for instance, his company pays for his rent. Not getting that.
No, we have what was left over from the advance in a bank account. We have an accountant, and he gives us a little bit of money every month to live. But we've been on tour and we've been recording for so long that I haven't had a chance. I got evicted from my apartment about 3 months ago, and every time we come back, we only have a few days at home, so I usually just go to my mother's, and I haven't found a place to live yet.
So you're still struggling, though.
No, we're not struggling. I think we're, no, financially we're well off. I mean, it's more money than I've ever had in my life. You know, to be able to pay rent every month, it's great. You know, I can't ask for any more.
So you're having fun then?
Oh yeah, definitely. It's taken a lot of problems away, you know.
Question about the new album. Why did you choose Butch Vig to help produce the new album, Nevermind?
Because we attempted to record our album about a year and a half ago in Madison, and the demos turned out really well, so we decided to do it again.
What, that Wisconsin sound?
The Wisconsin sound, yeah.
The lumberjack sound. When you got signed to the new label, did you find any sort of internal pressure to tone your sound down? Or do they pretty much leave it up to
there's
you?
There's no pressure at all whatsoever. In fact, when we had our first mixes completed, our A&R man said they weren't raw enough. Pretty surprising, but it's true.
Wow.
Yeah.
Were you apprehensive at all about signing to Giffen?
Well, with Geffen specifically, no. I mean,
but the MCA
had all the confidence in him. A lot of the other labels we were talking to, I was really worried. Because, signing away 7 years of your life is kind of a major decision.
Right.
But with Geffen, it's fine.
Okay, I read in Meat Magazine, it's a Hamilton and Toronto-based magazine, that you're a big fan of rap, but dislike white rap groups because, and this is a quote, the white man has ripped off the black man for long enough. Then how do you feel about Consolidated?
I don't know. Was I drunk at that time?